Assalamu alaikum, Sameer Soge with you. In this video, I'll be reviewing B101 module from Auvidea. What this module does is it takes an HDMI input from your laptop, computer, set-top box, camera, etc. and it feeds into the Raspberry Pi, and the Raspberry Pi can then preview it or record it. The price for this board is 70 euros. This is a discounted price as of now. The actual price is 140 euros. This board contains a Toshiba TC358743XBG chip. This is capable of 1080p 60 input. Unfortunately, the Raspberry Pi H.264 encoder is capable of only taking in 1080p 30. On top of that, the driver for this board supports only 720p. That is also because once Raspberry Pi Foundation had made a prototype board which contained the same chip. This board is not capable of taking interlaced video in. Also, it is not capable of taking HDCP protected content. The FFC cable you see over here is not the same as the one which comes with the Raspberry Pi. As in this, the contacts are both on the same side. According to Auvidea, this board is meant for software developers, and there is no support as such from Auvidea. But I think it is a pretty usable device. What this is capable of and what it isn't, we will see further in the video. Also, one more thing, whatever the device is capable of now, it is surely much more capable of it if software developers get on board, because the drivers and softwares are missing for this device. If they are made, this board can be of much more use than it is now. There is a thread on Raspberry Pi forum which deals with this board. So I would request all the guys who have knowledge in software, they get on board so that we can make this more usable. So let's get straight into the demos. Our first demo is going to be about a Raspberry Pi Model B and a camera. So this is the module I have connected to the Raspberry Pi via the FFC cable. The operating system I'm using is Raspbian Jessie of May 2016. It is kernel version 4.4, and the support for this module has been since kernel 4.1. So let's start. Okay, I'll connect the camera to the module. Okay. First, I'll just run a Raspberry Vid and show you, then I'll show the capture. So the output of the camera is now seen on the Raspberry Pi display. Let's record it now. I'll record it for say 10 seconds. And I have to specify this parameters or else it will capture in the default parameters of Raspberry Vid. I know that the camera will only output 720p 50. That is because the EDID advertised by the Toshiba board is 720p, and that is because of the driver present for the chip in the Raspberry Pi. So as you can see, it is showing, and now I have also started the camera. Let's play it and see. In this demo, I'll be capturing the output of the laptop via the HDMI cable, and it is going into this Raspberry Pi 3 connected to an official 7-inch display. I'll show the back. So this is the Raspberry Pi 3. This is the Awesam module connected on top of it, and the HDMI cable which is coming from the laptop. Okay, so I'll do a test run of 20 seconds and see. As you can see, it is mirroring the display. Okay, I'll show the graphics property and show that this thing is being shown as a monitor. So as you can see, we have digital television Toshiba H2C. This is the monitor, and it's having a resolution of 720p and 60Hz. So this is what the laptop gets from the Toshiba chip in the form of EDID. Now what we'll do is we'll capture the output. Okay, since we know that it is a 720p, we'll set the parameters for 720p and 60 because it was outputting at 60. Okay, this is the monitor. Let's do something. Google something. Okay, anyway, so the Raspberry Pi has recorded this thing. I'll play it again and show you. As you can see, it is much faster. When we convert it into MP4 using MP4 box, you can set the correct frame rate and then it will play properly. For this demo, I have connected the HDMI output of one Raspberry Pi into the B101 connected to another Raspberry Pi. What I'm doing is I have set the source Raspberry Pi HDMI resolution to 1080p 25. This is to show you that 1080p 25 works from one HDMI source into the B101 module. Raspberry Pi only works when the source Raspberry Pi boots. If you run Raspberry Pi, if the Raspberry Pi is already booted, it will not work. In this demo, I'm repeating the same connection as before. The HDMI output of one Raspberry Pi is going to B101 module connected to another Raspberry Pi. As you can see that the output is garbled as the output of source Raspberry Pi is set to 1080p 30. From this, we come to know that the max supported resolution is 1080p 25. This could change in the future, depends upon the work done by software developers. Thanks for watching and do subscribe.